This tutorial will walk you through the different areas of the Xcode workspace. Let's start with an existing project. The project on the screen is our Hello World project from the last tutorial. Let's take a look at all the different areas within the Xcode workspace. At the top, you'll see the toolbar. Now on the toolbar, you'll find lots of controls for compiling, running, and debugging your code. The toolbar will also include a status display, which will be found here in the middle, and view selectors on the right-hand side. The navigation area can be found on the far left-hand side of your screen, and in the navigation area you'll find navigators for files, symbols, and debugging information. The navigation select bar also allows you to select from available navigators. The filter bar, which is down here at the bottom, will allow you to search within the navigator. The editor area is where we're going to do most of our work. The breakpoint gutter is on the left, and it'll include areas for breakpoints, line numbers, and other indicators that will be related to the code that we'll be working with in the editor. The focus ribbon will allow you to focus on the structure of your code. Jump bars are used to select the content of the editors. Your debug area is down here at the bottom. It's split into two sections, the debug window on the left and the console window on the right. We'll use this area quite extensively throughout the follow-up tutorials. The utility area is over here on the right. And the utility area contains the inspector pane, which contains information and options for various types of files that we may be working with in the editor. And down here at the bottom, it also contains the library pane, which uses a selector bar to select between different types of libraries. So this should have introduced you briefly to the Xcode 4 workspace. As we go through follow-up tutorials, we'll talk through extensively through these different areas.